My first flight in the DA-20 was definitely a personal accomplishment and an enjoyable experience, but I think professionally, the significance of my role that I was filling as an enlisted pilot hit me when I graduated the pilot training at Randolph Air Force Base. Just seeing the people that were excited for us and the different women too, especially for me being able to fill that first female enlisted pilot role for the Air Force, didn't hit me until that graduation, and it was a story for everybody. My whole Air Force career has been spent doing ISR, so intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance. And it's a mission that I've grown passionate about, that being able to do my job, I started looking at the imagery, and then I moved to actually being able to provide the imagery. And so I wanted to be the pilot to be able to command those missions now. You know, I've started from the ground up. The purpose of having the enlisted pilots is, there's a couple of reasons. One of them is to open up the officers to be able to go back and fly manned platforms. And the Air Force has decided, you know, to reach into the skill set of our enlisted force to fill that gap there. And we're experimenting with the RQ-4 program. So to be able to release those pilots back into manned assets, we need to take over key positions within the squadron that have been held for so long by officers. So finding that transition point is definitely a challenge. Training's easy, you know, because regardless of what your rank is, you train to the same expectation, the same standard. You know, I'm hopeful in the future for the enlisted pilots, like you said, it's an equal playing field for the officers, so we won't be seen as enlisted or officer pilots, but we'll just be seen as pilots. And then I also hope too that the success of integrating the enlisted pilots into the RQ-4 platform shows successful to where we can start branching out into other assets in the Air Force.